Yes, he is. He will help Lot. Okay, so here we go. We're going to see. Remember, God sent two angels down to the city. What city? Sodoma. He sent two angels down to Sodom in English to go see Lot and to go look at the city. And then now look at chapter 19, verse number 12. What happened when they went to the city? Look at chapter 19, verse number 12. Y dijeron los varones a Lot, ¿tienes aquí alguno más, yernos y tus hijos y tus hijas y todo lo que tienes en la ciudad? Sácalo de este lugar. So, these are the angels talking to Lot to tell him to get out of this place because God was going to destroy it. So, believe me, not his whole family was justo, but God was going to save his family for Abraham. Look at verse number 13. Porque vamos a destruir este lugar por cuanto el clamor contra ellos ha subido de punto delante de Jehová. Por tanto, Jehová nos ha enviado para destruirlo. Entonces salió Lot y habló a sus yernos, los que habían de tomar sus hijos, hijas, y les dijo, levantaos, salid de este lugar, porque Jehová va a destruir esta ciudad. Mas pareció a sus yernos como que se burlaba. So look, he went to go save his family, to go tell them to come out of the land just like he was going to do. And they just laughed at him. They just called him crazy, just like the people did with Noah. Remember? They did the same thing. So were they going to go? Mm-mm. Nope. Look what it says in verse number 15. Y al rayar el alba, los ángeles daban prisa a Lot, diciendo, levántate, toma tu mujer y tus dos hijas que se hallan aquí, para que no perezcas en el castigo de la ciudad. Y deteniéndose él, los varones asieron de su mano y de la mano de su mujer y de las manos de sus dos hijas, según la misericordia de Jehová. Look at that, misericordia de Jehová. What's misericordia? When God gives us something that we don't merecer, that we don't deserve, right? Like, perdón. Look what it says, según la misericordia de Jehová para con él. Y lo sacaron y lo pusieron fuera de la ciudad. Y cuando los hubieron llevado fuera, dijeron, escapa por tu vida. No mires tras ti, ni pares en toda esta llanura. Escapa al monte, no sea que perezcas. So the angels took them out of the city, okay, and gave them specific instructions. Remember, God expects us to do what? To obey. So he gave them specific instructions. What were they? No mires tras ti, ni pares en toda esta llanura. Escapa al monte, no sea que perezcas. Look what it says. Lot didn't want to do that. Look at verse number 19. Pero Lot les dijo, no, yo os ruego, señores míos. He aquí ahora ha hallado vuestro siervo gracia en vuestros ojos y habéis engrandecido vuestra misericordia que habéis hecho conmigo dándome la vida. Mas yo no podré escapar al monte, no sea que me alcance el mal y muera. He aquí ahora esta ciudad está cerca para huir allá, la cual es pequeña. Dejadme escapar ahora allí. No es ella pequeña, y salvaré mi vida. So he wanted to go into the city, not into the monte. So what do you think the angel said? He didn't want to go back into the bad city. He just wanted to go into a small city by Sodoma because he was afraid of going into the monte. So look what it says in verse number 21. Y le respondió, he aquí he recibido también tu súplica sobre esto, y no destruiré la ciudad de que has hablado. Date prisa, escápate allá, porque nada podré hacer hasta que hayas llegado allí. Por eso fue llamado el nombre de la ciudad Zoar. El sol salía sobre la tierra cuando Lot llegó a Zoar, Entonces Jehová hizo llover sobre Sodoma y sobre Gomorra azufre y fuego de parte de Jehová desde los cielos. So fire was coming down, rocks were coming down from heaven to destroy this city. Y destruyó las ciudades y toda aquella llanura con todos los moradores de aquellas ciudades y el fruto de la tierra. But look at what happened. Look at what happened when we don't obey. Look what it says in verse number 26. Entonces la mujer de Lot miró atrás a espaldas de él y se volvió estatua de sal. Okay, so here it is. The angels told them, do not look back. Do not look back. She didn't obey. She looked back, and what happened to her? She turned into a statue of salt. And you think, that didn't happen. Yes, it did. Yes, it did. Okay, look what it says in verse number 27. Y subió por la mañana al lugar donde había estado delante de Jehová. I'll remind you of the picture again. Here comes Abraham in the morning to look at it. Y subió Abraham, right? Y miró hacia Sodoma y Gomorra. Y hacia toda la tierra de aquella llanura miró. Y he aquí que el humo subía de la tierra como el humo de un horno. Así cuando destruyó Dios las ciudades de la llanura, Dios se acordó de Abraham y envió fuera a Lot de en medio de la destrucción, al asolar las ciudades donde Lot estaba. Okay, so because of Abraham, God saved Lot's life that day. Okay, that's a really, really sad situation, but I'm going to leave you with a happy, happy story about a little baby boy. What little baby boy am I talking about? After all that happened, who was born? The baby of Abraham and his wife, who? Sarah. And what was the baby's name? Anybody remember? God gave him a name. Isaac. So let's see that really quick, and then we'll be done for today. It says, look over in chapter 21. Chapter 21, verse number 1. Visitó Jehová a Sara, como había dicho, e hizo Jehová con Sara como había hablado. Y Sara concibió y dio a Abraham un hijo en su vejez. How old was Abraham when Sarah was born? I mean, when Isaac was born? 99, okay? And it says, en el tiempo que Dios le había dicho, y llamó Abraham el nombre de su hijo que le nació, que le dio a luz Sara, Isaac. Y circuncidó Abraham a su hijo Isaac de 8 días, como Dios le había mandado. Y era Abraham de 100 años cuando nació Isaac su hijo. So 99 when God told him he was going to have she was going to have the baby, and 100 by the time she had it, since she had the baby for 9 months. Entonces dijo Sara, Dios me ha hecho reír, y cualquiera que lo oyere se reirá conmigo. Y añadió, quien dijera a Abraham que Sara habría de dar de mamar a hijos, pues le ha dado un hijo en su vejez. Y creció el niño y fue destetado, e hizo Abraham gran banquete el día que fue destetado Isaac. Y vio Sara que el hijo de Hagar, en English, la egipcia, el cual le había dado a luz a Abraham, se burlaba de su hijo Isaac. Okay, so they had this grand celebration, and everybody's happy for Isaac and Sarah for having a baby in her vejez when she's old, just like God promised. But now there's going to be a problem with the other baby, right? Ishmael. But we'll figure out that problem when? We will figure that out next week on Monday, okay, you guys? So there was a lot of things going on today, but what can we learn? That God does have mercy and God is always going to cumplir his promesas. He's always going to tell the truth. We never have to worry that God is not going to be honest with us, but we need to obey him, just like Lot and his wife needed to learn. Okay, let me get the homework for you and show you what we're going to do today.
Okay, guys, I'll put the picture of this at the very end of the lesson, but remember, today you're going to do anything that's left in entry 4. So you have write one thought from your Bible reading this week. Okay, so one thing you learned, one thing that you thought was interesting, okay? Then write the theme for this week. So what was the tema? Like, what were some lecciones that you learned? Like, obedience is one, right? So write some things that you learned. The people in this week's Bible lessons were, there's like at least six people you can put in there about who was in our stories this week. And what I want to remember from this week's Bible lesson is, what do you guys want to remember, okay? Then you're going to do this down here, and actually you're going to read a part of the story that we're going to learn on Monday. What? Okay, cool. It says, what were the consequences for Lot's wife when she chose not to obey? Uh-oh. What were the consequences? But also you're going to read chapter 21, verses 17 through 20, and tell me, what did Ishmael do when he and Hagar needed water in the desert? Ooh, I didn't tell you about that part, so you got to go find it. Don't write, I don't know. You gotta go look for it in the Bible. Then it says, how did God answer his prayer? And read Jeremiah 33:3. I love that verse, you guys. Have fun when you look at that verse. Will God answer your prayers? Obviously, we know the answer is yes, but go look up the verse, por favor. It's very, very beautiful. Okay, here we go. Let's pray. And I hope you guys have an amazing weekend. And I hope you're having fun learning about Abraham and all the crazy adventures that he is going to have with God. Let's pray. Dear Lord, thank you so much for today. And thank you for each of these students. I pray that you help them this weekend to get some rest. I pray that you help each of their families, protect them from the virus, Lord. Help everyone to be safe and healthy and to not get this virus, Lord. I pray that you take it off the island and take it out of the world as fast as possible, but also help us to trust you and to continue to work hard for you and do our best. In Jesus' name, amen. Bye, guys. Love you.